if you like fun games, if you like weird games, if you like anything I've ever made, this game's got a lot of that. I actually came up with the idea for Tapeworm 9 years ago. It was right around development of Binding of Isaac, the original. Just got a wild hair up my ass about making a spatial card game. A game that felt like it was dynamically driven by the players and that space meant something. Like I like the idea of things interlocking and connecting. I also wanted to make a game that my nieces and nephews could play and they were really young, so I wanted to make something as simple as Uno, but have a good amount of depth so adults could play it. And then it's also weird and cute and gross and works with all the aesthetics that I'm known for. We can say that it's tied to Isaac in some way if that makes you buy it. I'll make one that looks like it's crying. It's a game about playing your hand out and making one long colored segment of worm to try to play all your cards in your hand. Everybody draws 5 cards, and the person who resembles a worm the most, they go first. You always start out with a start card, which has 3 main segments on it. And on your turn, you can build off of one of those colors. So you can say, I'm building off of pink. And then you can continue to play cards that are pink until they either end or segment into another color. You stop playing cards, it goes to the next person, and then they continue to do the same. But there's also cards that have abilities, essentially. What Dig does is it allows you to draw a card and then discard any card from your hand. And then Switch lets you choose another player, look at their hand, steal a card from their hand, give them one of your junky cards. Then there's Peek, which lets you look at the top card of the library, take it to your hand and put a card on top, or put that card back on top so the next person draws it. And then there's Cut, which lets you cut a segment dependent on the color of the cut. You could cut red and then continue to build off of red. You could cut white, continue to build off of white. You've got the angry red worm. He's all pissed and veiny, angry. And then you've got the little cutesy pink worm who has like a little doodle on its head. It falls in love with anybody that they come into contact with. You've got the nervous white worm. He's usually square, like he has like a flat top head. And then there's the black worm, which looks confused and is all rotty and full of little worms. So the base game will just have the base game, which will just be the cards and instruction manual. And then there's the special version, is a nice foily version, which is a limited edition one. And that's the one you wanna really go for because that will include all of like the unlocks for Kickstarter, which we have a bunch planned, a bunch of Four Souls cards I have designed that I would really like to put in. I would appreciate it a lot if you would tell everybody that you've ever met in your life and every person you talk to online about this. I really like this little game. It's super simple, casual, fun, easy pick up and play card game. It could be a palate cleanser between games. It could be just something you play with your family. Super user friendly, super easy to play, and it feels a lot different than other games because of its spatial elements. There's a good amount of strategy to it that will make you feel smart.